Hi, my name is Guilherme Lacerda. I am PhD student at URGS. Together with my research partners, Fabio Petrillo, Marcelo Pimenta, and Gael, I will present our work, Cold Smells and Refactoring, a tertiary systematic literature review of challenges and observations. Our work was published at JSS 167, and preprint is available using this address below. In the past decades, refactoring and smells have been well researched by the software engineering research community. Tertiary studies are reviews of reviews, using secondary studies in a given area. The software engineering community accepted these studies as useful and helpful. We identified 40 secondary studies. We analyzed the studies to identify the most discussed topics. We then explore these topics in detail, summarizing the observations and challenges related to these topics. We name an observation that is what we know, a consensus in the literature, and challenge what we don't know is a topic still open and to be better explored. Our study answers 5 research questions. RQ1. What refactoring-related topics have been investigated in secondary studies? RQ2. What smell-related topics have been investigated in secondary studies? RQ3. Which tools have been mentioned for cold smell detection and refactoring support? RQ4. Which RQs have been studied on cold smell and refactoring? What are the highest cited secondary studies? RQ5. What are the annual trend of types, quality, and the number of primary studies reviewed by the secondary studies? So, we categorized the refactoring topics from 13 studies. The main topics were opportunities, techniques, refactoring tools, refactoring in other contexts such as architectural refactoring, and others. We can apply more than one refactoring techniques to a smell. It may even be necessary to combine more than one refactoring to remove it or reduce its impact. Else, some refactoring can be applied in more than one smell. Extraction techniques like extract class and extract method are the most mentioned. Number of techniques explored is still small, between 20 and 27 of 72. Quality metrics-oriented approach, condition-oriented approach, and cluster-oriented approach are the most cited approaches to find refactoring opportunities. And refactoring is primary approach to minimize the effects of technical debt. However, some refactoring when applied negatively affected the quality attributes. In the same way, we also categorized the smell topics from 26 studies. The main topics were smell detection, cold smell description, tools for smell detection, and others. The smell naming standardization process is necessary to allow the unification of terminology. Co-occurrence can be more explored, such as the appearance of smell in consequence of another smell, smells that are always close, presence of one implies the presence of another, among the others. Bob and duplicated code clones are the most mentioned design and code smell respectively. Related to the technical debt, God class, large class has been the most investigated smells. Metric-oriented approach and strategies and roles are the most cited approaches to smell detection. Other approaches such as history-based, optimization-based, probabilistic search-based, and visualization have also been used to detect smells. It is necessary to develop tools that support more than one programming language. Also, it is necessary to expand the studies and experiments, improving the accuracy of the smell detection tools and refactoring support. We identify a lack of maturity of tools, with limitations that restrict their use and adoption by the industry. Several aspects characterize tools, such as license, supported languages, degree of automation, and others. Java is the platform programming language most used. We found a large number of smell detection tools, detecting only a tiny amount of smells, between 3 and 4. The number of refactoring tools is small. Finally, CC Finder and J. Deodorant are the most cited tools. We identified the need for studies that contain more sophisticated RQs. With the increase of empirical studies on smells and refactoring, we considered the new possibilities of secondary studies covering RQs about causality and design. We identified 181 RQs in 40 selected studies. Some studies had no explicitly defined RQs or even did not follow a defined protocol. There is no relation between study comprehensiveness and the number of RQs. The scope of the study is related to the scope of RQ itself, and not necessarily with the number of RQs. There is a lack of validation by experts in the field. Experts should participate more effectively in the experiments. Another challenge is the lack of benchmarks. We note a growth of secondary studies in recent years. The vast majority of studies are systematic literature reviews, around 65%, with 75% of studies published in journals. Cold smells are symptoms or design problems that may affect the evolution and maintenance of the software. Some of these cold smells are small, and we call the simple smell. Often, the occurrence of one cold smell may be related or to correlated with another cold smell. We also summarized some interesting characteristics of refactoring. We note that there are simple refactoring, known as primitive refactorings. Often, for a given situation, we need to perform a sequence of refactoring, known as composite refactoring. Also, we present the more known tools supporting refactoring. As we showed earlier, looking at the cold smells and refactoring in isolation, we noticed that there are some similar characteristics. Cold smells and refactoring affect software quality. Refactoring cold smells are linked because refactoring is the main strategy to remove and mitigate cold smells, improving the software quality. We also know that refactoring, if improperly applied, can generate new cold smells and, consequently, affect the quality negatively. So, we present a scheme of the relationship with the specified characteristics of cold smells and refactoring, as well as the elements that connected them. So, cold smells and refactoring are closely related to software quality. According to analyzed studies, we present in this paper a more in-depth discussion about quality, smells, and refactoring. The attributes of quality most affected by cold smells are maintainability, understandability, and complexity. The cold smell the most affected different quality attributes are gold class, large class, long method, and feature envy. Duplicated cold clones have more refactoring that can be applied. Refactoring is flexible, can be applied in more than one cold smell. It is the case of extract class, move method, and extract method. We note the quality attributes most affected by cold smells are also the ones most affected by refactoring. Refactoring affects quality more than cold smells. It demonstrates that this relationship is not only due to the cold smell with refactoring, but the origin of the relationship is quality. We organize the main observations and challenges about cold smell in their refactories into smell definition, most common cold smell detection approach, cold smell detection tools, most common refactoring and refactoring tools. Cold smells and refactoring have a strong relationship with quality attributes, such as understandability and maintainability. We also discussed the implications of these works for practitioners, researchers, and instructors. We identified 13 open issues that could guide future research work. We want to highlight the gap between cold smells and refactoring the current states of software engineering research. We wish that this work could be help the software engineering research community in collaborating on future works on cold smells and refactoring. Thank you.